Good morning everyone. In the previous class, we have discussed what is HTML tag. An HTML tag is nothing but a label added to the text that is to be shown on the web page. So here, first we are going to discuss the four types of HTML tags. And the first one is called HTML. The HTML is used to tell the browser that the text contained between the opening tag and closing tag of HTML is a web page and can be viewed on a web browser. Which means whenever we are starting an HTML tag, it should be started with the code called HTML. Then only the web browser can understand we are going to create a web page. So every web page coding must start with the HTML opening tag and end with the closing tag of HTML. So it is a container tag. So always we should start our HTML code with the tag called HTML and end with the closing tag of HTML. Okay, and the second type of basic tag is called head. A head tag is used to define the header area of your web page. For a web page, there are usually two sections. One is header part and second one is body part. So all the information given in the head tag that tells the computer that information is not to be shown on the web page. So whatever information we are giving in a header section that will not shown on the web page. So the head tag is a container tag used in pairs of opening tag and closing tag of head. And every web page coding must have its header specified. So it is important to use the head tag in a code. Our third basic HTML tag is called title. A title tag is used to tell the web browser that the text contained between the opening tag and closing tag of title is a text that does not a part of the web page. It will be shown on the title bar or the title tab of the web browser. So, whatever information or data we are giving in between the opening tag and closing tag of the title, it will be shown on the title bar only. So, the use of the title tag is not mandatory. We can avoid if we don't want to give any title for the web page. If you don't want to give any title to your web page, your web browser will show the file name and its path as the title of the web page. So, we can avoid the title for the web page. And the last tag is called body. A body tag is used to tell the web browser that the text contained between the opening tag and the closing tag of the body is to be shown on the web page. So whatever data we are giving in between the opening tag and closing tag of body, that will be shown on the web page. It is also a container tag. And in the case of body tag, it has two main attributes. Now let's check what are the two types of attributes supported by body. And the first one is called BG color. BG color stands for background color. This attribute allows you to define a color for the background of our web page. And here you can see one example. Body, after that we have to give a space, then BG color equal to red. The value of the color should be given in double quotes. Then only it will be appear on the web page. And the second attribute is called text. The text attribute allows to define a color for the text of our web page. It should be given in double quotes also. So there are two types of attributes supported by body tag. One is BG color and second one is text. And before that, do you know what is attribute? Before discussing about the body attribute, we should know what is attribute. Now let's check what is tag attributes. The tag attributes can be added to HTML tag. An attribute is defined as an additional feature that can be added to the HTML elements on the web page. So we can give some extra or additional features to the HTML tag to make our web page more attractive. We can add some background colors, foreground colors, images. We can align the text. That all additional features we can add to our web page by using the feature called tag attribute. Now let's check how we can design a simple web page by using the four basic HTML tags. As we have discussed, always we should start the HTML tag with HTML. So First, we have to type the opening tag HTML, because by using this tag, we are going to tell the web browser that we have started to create a web page. Okay. And after the HTML, we can give the second tag as the head. Okay. So, head tag, we are using to define the header area of our web page. Before giving the closing tag of head, we have to give the title tag. Okay. The title tag we have to type just after the opening tag of head. So, here I am going to type the title tag. After the opening tag of title, we can give the title for our web page, which should be present on the title bar of the web browser. So, here I am giving my first web page. Okay, that is my heading for the web browser. So, after giving the title, we can close the title tag. Okay, here I am going to close the title tag. After closing the title tag, I am going to close the head tag. Now, the header section of the web page is over. Okay, as I told you, there are two sections for the web page. First one is header section and second one is body section. So, after closing the header part, I started body part. Okay, so I have given the body tag here. And we have studied, we can use two attributes for our body tag. So, here I am going to give the two attributes for our web page. Near to the body tag, I am going to give the BG color and text attributes. So, after body, give one space and type BG color. After typing BG color, give an equal to sign and in double quotes, we can give any color. Suppose here I am going to give green. So, in double quotes, we can give green, then give one space, then type text. Text attribute we are using for giving the color for the letters. Okay, so text, then again equal to, in double quotes, give any color. Here I am giving white color. Okay, so after giving the attribute only, we should complete the angular bracket. We have studied that all the tags in an HTML should be given in between the angular brackets. So, after the tag name, give the attribute. Finally, we have to give the angle bracket. This is how we have to apply attribute. Then I am going to type welcome to HTML. This is the body part of the web page. So, the welcome to HTML should be shown on the body part of our web page. And my first web page should be appear on the title bar of the web page. After that, I have closed the body tag and finally HTML. The HTML closing tag should be given at last only. Okay, then only it will be completely considered as a web page. So, after typing all these tags, we have to save our file. So, let's click on the file tab, then save. Now, save as dialog box appeared and in the file name area, we have to give our file name. Here, I am going to give one file name. After giving the file name, we should give the extension. Okay, first file name, then .html. That is our extension. Then we can click on the option save. Okay, now we are going to save this one. Now, we have saved our file as a web page. Whenever we are giving the extension HTML, that time only our file will be saved as a web page. Suppose we want to make some changes in the HTML document, we can right click on the file icon. One list will come. Among that, we can see an option called Open With. There are lot of web browser symbol we can see. Along with that, Notepad also we can see. We can just click on the option Notepad, then we can go to the source file. So, whatever changes we have to made in the code that we can done from here. And after making the changes, we can click on the option called Save and we can close this one. So, that changes will be appear on the web page. Okay, this is how we can change the source code. We can just click our mouse right button on the file icon. Then, click on the option Open With. Then, select Notepad. Then, we can open the code and we can make the changes and click on the save again. Whenever we are double clicking on the file, we can open our web page. Now, you can see this is our simple web page. Okay, welcome to HTML, we can see on the web page body part. the title which we have given on the code we cannot see here, because that will be available on the title bar of the web browser only. So this is how we can create a simple web page by using the tag.